NFL Live on KSHP is sponsored by your local Dodge dealers and by Price Chopper, the official grocery sponsor of the Kansas City Chiefs.
This is the NBC Television Network. This is NFL Live for Week 12 with host Greg Gumbel and co-host Ahmad Rashad.
A crucial game in rainy Kansas City as the surprise team of the year, the Cleveland Browns, take on the Kansas City Chiefs. Joe Montana needs to get the Kansas City offense in gear today. The Chiefs have averaged just 12 points in their last three games. Another fine AFC matchup at Three Rivers Stadium in Pittsburgh. The 7-3 Steelers, a game back of Cleveland, host the 7-3 Miami Dolphins. And it's a homecoming for Dan Marino, who grew up in the Pittsburgh area. The Dolphins are looking to bounce back from last week's upset at the hands of the Chicago Bears. And hi once again, everyone. I'm Greg Gumbel, along with Mike Ditka and Joe Gibbs. Ahmad, Will McDonough, Jim Gray will all join us shortly. One of my favorite phrases in football is crunch time. Are we at crunch time yet?
Well, I'll tell you what, you're at an important time for two teams, Kansas City and Buffalo. These are two of the best teams in the AFC, but they're on the bubble right now. These are two must-win games, in my opinion, or they forget about the playoffs.
Joe, this is an important time of the year.
Very important, particularly for home field advantage. Chances are the teams that are going to go to the Super Bowl, that have a chance to win the Super Bowl, must get home field. That's being determined right now.
All right, gentlemen, two very good AFC matchups on tap today. We begin with Cleveland at Kansas City. The Browns are 8-2 and have some believers now after crushing the Eagles in Philadelphia last week. Despite the good record, Cleveland has an unsettled quarterback situation between Vinny Testaverde and Mark Rippon. Testaverde suffered a concussion 3 weeks ago. Rippon has started the last two games. Joe Gibbs was in Cleveland.
From a player standpoint, should a starter lose his job because of an injury?
As a player, you want to play. I know I wanted to play, and I'm sure Vinny wants to play. But the bottom line is these guys have come in and they played well, and the team has been winning. So I think you have to put the team ahead of everybody else and realize that as long as if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
I'm not going to get caught up in that. The only thing I'm going to try and do to help this team win is to prepare like I'm going to start the game. And if I don't, then I don't.
With quarterbacks, you know, without getting into any controversy, that's a difficult subject. And I think Bill's dealt with it in the best way possible. And he knows that throughout these last 6 weeks, both of us are going to have to be ready to play and win games.
The Cleveland Browns are just finishing their last practice in preparation for their big game against Kansas City. They've not announced who the starting quarterback's going to be. But the question is, with this defense and special teams, does it really matter?
We have a great defense, and as long as we play consistent on offense, not create the big plays for their defense, not give the turnovers up easy, that we should win a lot of games that way. And so far it's worked out, and things are starting to pick up on offense for us as well.
Okay, I got to put you on the spot. Who should start Sunday?
Well, I think the team definitely has a good feeling behind Rip at this point. We've won two good games. The offense has performed well. And I think you risk disrupting that if you make a change, especially at that position.
Mark Rippon comes in, has played well, helped his team win. And now there's all this talk about a quarterback controversy. But, you know, I just feel like that I'm still the starting quarterback until Bill Belichick says otherwise, and that's the way I'm approaching it.
Who's your starting quarterback?
Oh, goodness gracious. I didn't know you were going to do this to me. Brad Gable.
Brad Gable is definitely the third-string quarterback. Who will start today for Cleveland? For that, we go to Marv Albert and Paul McGuire in Kansas City. Gentlemen.
All right, Greg. Yes, Bill Belichick has been very secretive, very elusive as to who will start at quarterback for the Cleveland Browns today, but we've learned it will be Mark Rippon. Vinny Testaverde, coming back from the concussion, is ready after sitting out 2 weeks with that concussion. So both are available, but it will be Rippon as the starter.
And Coach Bill Belichick is doing the right thing. Rippon's coming off of two victories in a row, and besides that, he's got his former starting quarterback in the wings if something happens to Rippon.
Now, Cleveland has had its share of injuries, but The Kansas City Chiefs have been battered. Seven starters sidelined today on offense. Marcus Allen, Willie Davis, John Ault will not play. Three key players, tight end Keith Cash, has been out for a while. On defense, a huge loss. Neil Smith, who leads the AFC with 11 and a half sacks, will be sitting it out because of an elbow problem. Also out, starting defensive backs Mark Collins and David Whitmore.
And Marty Schottenheimer all week long has been trying to convince his healthy players, don't use this as an excuse to lose to the Cleveland Browns. But in reality, if you look down that sideline, you're going to see about one-third of their salary cap in street clothes.
And, Paul, weather can certainly be a factor here today, a driving rain falling right throughout the day in Kansas City, leading to this question a half hour before kickoff. Why are these people sitting here in the rain? Greg?
All right, gentlemen, thank you. So Mark Rippon gets the start. Joe, number one, is that a good decision? And number two, does it really matter who starts?
I've enjoyed kind of seeing Mark squirm around there. I actually had him in the hot seat there. Let me answer that question. Does it matter who starts? You bet your life. The coach's biggest decision is who starts at quarterback. He's going to determine audibles and how that game goes. I think this is a good decision starting Rip.
All right, Paul McGuire had his calculator out. A third of the Chiefs' salary cap on the sidelines watching. Sometimes an injured team fights back tough. What do you think?
You know, Greg, we had an old saying in Chicago that a wounded bear could still bite. We're going to find out if a wounded chief without teeth has any bite.
Did you put that on a T-shirt and sell it somewhere?
I have T-shirts made up. If you want one, I can get you one.
For a look at some of the other big games, here's Ahmad.
We start with a game in Pittsburgh between the Steelers and the Dolphins. Both teams are 7-3. Miami is ranked first in the league in offense. Pittsburgh is first in the conference in defense. For a quick preview, we bring in Todd Christensen at Three River Stadium.
Ahmad, thanks a lot. You know, this is the time of the year where injuries abound, and Miami and Pittsburgh are no exception. Jeff Cross, starting defensive end, and Cleveland Gary, their newly acquired third down back, did not even make the trip. But good news for the Miami Dolphin offense is the return of Bernie Parmalee. Bernie Parmalee had really been the bellwether of the offense, particularly in the running game. During his starts, he had averaged over 100 yards per start, and the free agent from Ball State is certainly a key to the success of the Miami Dolphin offense today. On the other side, the Pittsburgh offense has been struggling. They have not scored an offensive touchdown in the last 10 quarters. Neil O'Donnell is banged up with a sprained ankle and a hurt hip. And as a result, they are going to start Mike Tomczak today in his place, which is interesting because of the fact that the local press here feels that maybe it's time for Neil O'Donnell to sit anyway. We'll see if Tomczak can jumpstart the Pittsburgh offense today, Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Todd. Green Bay visits Buffalo in another good matchup today. The Packers have won three straight and are 6-4. The Bills are 5-5 and struggling just to make it into the playoffs. Jim Gray joins us from outside Rich Stadium.
All right, Ahmad, thank you very much. This could be the beginning of the end of an era, because if the playoffs were to start today, the Buffalo Bills would not be in them for the first time since 1987. And the Bills have some more bad news this morning. Defensive end Bruce Smith, the perennial All-Pro player, will not play today because of a bad left shoulder. It's so badly bruised, in fact, last night at dinner, he was unable to lift his knife, so he is inactive for today. It's been a very bad week for the Bills. It started with that loss against Pittsburgh on Monday night. Jim Kelly was sacked 7 times in that game. In fact, he told owner Ralph Wilson after the game that it was the worst beating he has taken as a Bill. Now, that led to all kinds of frustration for Jim Kelly. He's seen screaming at head coach Marv Levy and Andre Reed. Well, Reed on his radio show Wednesday night said that he didn't like being yelled at on national TV. Felt he was treated like a little kid and that Kelly had acted like a fool. Well, this morning, Kelly responded to that.
And heat of the battle and things are said, and I just want everybody to realize that I want everybody on the same page as I'm on. I'm the quarterback, and whatever I say goes on the football field, and if they don't like it, that's their fault.
Wow, well, certainly the bickering Bills are back. As for the Packers, they're looking for their fourth straight win, and Sterling Sharp, who injured his hamstring in last week's game and sat out the fourth quarter, will play today. He told me he's feeling much better, and he will start. As for the Packers, well, it doesn't get much tougher than their schedule, because between now and the next 4 days, they will have to play on the road against both of last year's Super Bowl teams. Ahmad?
Thanks a lot, Jim, and folks, Jim is our bellwether. We've still got plenty ahead on today's show.
Coming up next, I'll talk to a former Viking receiver.
Well, Sammy White wasn't available, so I sat down for a conversation with the Vikings' Warren Moon. And we'll hear from the NFL's newest quarterback sensation, Jeff Blake of the Cincinnati Bengals. It's all coming up on NFL Live.
Obviously, a pizza is a canvas. This is the canvas. effect, and you can paint on it all day long.
Mm-hmm. California is what our restaurant is all about.
It's about choice. It's innovation, adventure, and freedom, and openness, and
sun-dried tomato, broccoli.
People that come here to take a chance. They're willing to try something they've never tried before. A pizza with chicken on it.
Or how about a pizza with potato on it?
Bean sprouts?
You think so?
We have no rules here.
We have watched where businesses have limited ways in which the customer pays. Why in the world would we choose to do that?
When they choose American Express, we gladly accept it.
We like choices, not limitations. That's very California.
American Express is welcome to California Pizza Kitchen and wherever fresh ideas are cooking. So dine out, America.
This holiday season, Radio Shack has a 486 AST Advantage computer on sale for the incredible price of $49 a month for 24 months with no interest.
Hey, there's lots of good reasons to buy one for the family. Dolores could balance her checkbook with it. Little Jimmy can do his homework. I can put the money we save right into his college fund.
Zero percent interest, 24 months, $49 a month only at Radio Shack.
Still going. Long-lasting Energizer batteries keep going.
I don't need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great. But it also cools and tones my skin. Confidence is very sexy. Don't you think?
Original and cooling blue.
By Menon.
NFL Live is brought to you by 3DO, the most advanced home gaming system in the universe. By Sierra, it's not just antifreeze, it's safety freeze. And by Goodyear, number one in tires.
Some of you will see our late game today between the Jets and the Vikings. Minnesota made one of the best moves of the offseason when it acquired Warren Moon from Houston. Now, while his former team is in turmoil, his current team is contending.
I wouldn't be able to do the things we're doing. Offensively, myself, Jake Reed, or as a whole, we would not be able to do the things we're doing without Warren.
A lot of the key reason for my success, you know, especially having a quarterback here who can get the ball to us.
Last time we talked, you said that you were just getting used to the offense. I guess you've adjusted now, having thrown for over 2,800 yards.
Yeah, I've adjusted pretty well. I think we've probably thrown the ball more than I thought we would this season. We've had some games where our running game hasn't been as consistent, and I've had to throw it a little bit more, but I think the more I've had to throw it, the more it's helped me get in tune to the offense.
How disappointing was it last week to not be able to seal the win, you know, after you guys got ahead? Just with a little bit of a running game, you guys sealed the win, not be able to get it.
Yeah, we would have been able to run the clock out and run a little bit more time off the clock if we would have been able to run a little bit more successfully. But that was disappointing that we weren't able to put that game away, because we did have control of it, and we let them get back into it. We let them get momentum back. The crowd got back into the game, and Drew Bledsoe got hot, and it made it a long afternoon for us after that.
How did the team deal with that loss? I mean, you guys were rolling pretty nice, rolling right along. All of a sudden, you get beat by New England. How'd the team deal with it?
Well, I think it was a wake-up call to everybody that we're not as good as we were probably starting to think, and what everybody was saying, that we have to go out and we have to play 60 minutes of hard football, which is what got us that 7-2 record in the first place. That we can't go out and cruise for a half and then all of a sudden think we can win the football game because we had a good half, and then the next half we can take off. We're not that good yet.
You spent so much time in Houston. A lot of things happening there this week. What's your take on that situation?
Well, I feel like, you know, Coach Pardee and Kevin Gilbride are probably the scapegoats for some of the bad decisions management made last year in getting rid of some pretty good football players. And when you run an offense that's dominated by the quarterback, you better have a quarterback that can run the offense. And I just don't think offensively they had the tools that they've had in the past, and that's one of the reasons why they haven't had the success. And because they haven't had the success, it's all come down on, you know, Gilbride and Pardee. But those guys, you know, they've taken the team to the playoffs the last 5 years with that offense, but you got to have the tools in order to run the offense.
Mike, we just heard what Warren had to say about the situation in Houston. What's your take?
He's right on the button. They undermined Jack Pardee a couple years ago when they brought Buddy Ryan in as a defensive coordinator. They said, hey, he's not your choice, he's our choice. We want him to be the defensive coach, and that was a mistake. The head coach has the authority to do that. Who's making the decisions in Houston? Is it the owner, the general manager, the player personnel guy? Somebody's got to make up their mind, because when they got rid of Warren Moon, they got rid of the run and shoot, and they were too dumb to see that. That's their fault. Jack Pardee is a good coach. His only problem is he's a nice guy. Nice guys don't finish first.
Well,
except Joe Gibbs. That's
right. I was about to say that, Joe, but what about Warren? He's doing well in Minnesota.
Hey, Warren Moon is loving life. First of all, he got rid of the run and shoot. He's got a tight end in there and some people to block for him. The other thing he got is something all quarterbacks covet, a great defense to get him the ball back. And the thing that I think a guy like this brings to the team, did you see him on the sideline over there with those players? I love a quarterback over there that's been around a while telling those guys, hey, we got to get it going.
All right. Warren Moon turned 38 on Friday, and Greg has the story of a much younger quarterback.
All right, Ahmad, one of our early games on NBC today, the Colts at the Bengals. Cincinnati, after the 0-8 start, has won two straight. The guy most responsible, 23-year-old quarterback Jeff Blake.
Welcome to Cincinnati at Riverfront Stadium, and the talk of the town is the Bengals' new quarterback, Jeff Blake, across the middle.
Blake puts my goodness, and he scores a touchdown!
Is this real? It's almost like the script to a movie.
Jeff Blake, the tremendous new quarterback at Cincinnati.
Released by the Jets in the preseason, Blake was picked up at the suggestion of Bruce Coslett, now the Bengals' offensive coordinator. He has put up tremendous numbers the last 3 weeks, and I asked Jeff if he got a fair shot in New York.
I really didn't, you know. I just kind of prepared myself through watching film, and while I was at the Jets this preseason, I really didn't do anything for us, taking reps, you know, so I just stood on sideline and watched. And when I watch, I kind of observe things and kind of learn from observing.
Well, the odds are definitely against you if you come out of college and you're not a high draft pick, or if you don't have a big reputation, especially if you're a quarterback, right?
Right. The odds are very against you, but you know, I've been going against the norm all my life, and all I had to do was just have an opportunity.
Don't you feel that there are instances around the National Football League where the size of a contract determines as much as anything else whether or not a guy plays or not?
Well, it does. You know, that's the difference between, like you said earlier, a first-round draft pick and a sixth-round draft pick. So, and that has a lot to do with that sixth-round draft pick getting a chance to play due to the fact that the first-round draft pick is making so much money.
Who is at fault, Jeff, when someone's talents go unnoticed or undiscovered?
In my opinion, I think a person should be judged by his character and by his heart, and not by his speed or by his size, you know, because a lot of people in the league nowadays are very under the norm for it's too small or too this or too that, but they are the league's greatest players.
Jeff Blake's pretty good story. How do you avoid a situation like this in the future? How can a guy get a good look coming out of school?
Well, it's hard, really. He was a late-round draft pick, but I like what he said about his character and his heart, because that's what's going to carry this kid.
Joe?
This is the one place at quarterback that you can miss a guy, because in order to evaluate a quarterback, you got to have everybody out there. You don't have enough games, enough scrimmages to get that done. You can't put them in drills like you can other people make an evaluation.
All right, Mike, Joe up next. Will McDonough joins us with details of Andre Rison's suspension. And Will will look at the defense of the Cleveland Browns, the toughest on which to score in the entire league.
If you're not playing on a 3DO system, what are you playing with? Presenting 3DO, the most advanced home gaming system in the universe. It's time to put away your toys.
3DO from Panasonic, Gold Star, and Creative Labs. Now $3.99 plus free games.
Over the last few years, a lot of people have seen their investments drop in value. Unfortunately, that's life. Our annuities have held their value and consistently paid higher rates than CDs. That's New York Life. New York Life, the company you keep.
Goodyear announces 25% off some of our most popular passenger, performance, and light truck radials. 25% off. But you gotta hurry. The sale ends December 3rd at participating Goodyear retailers.
Still going. Long-lasting Energizer batteries keep going.
Take it from Coach Schottenheimer. Cold weather's coming. If you kick on your old furnace and it doesn't kick back, call your man from Train. He's in the yellow pages under furnace.
Take comfort in the man from Train.
Now get a free CO detector with a cleaning check. With a new Train furnace, get a free 15-year warranty. Coach?
You can rely on your man from Train.
Elvin and Greg Wright, Elvin's Heating and Cooling.
Casey Pinoff, AFC Heating and Cooling.
Take comfort. Call your man from Train.
A quick look at the weather. Showers in both Kansas City and Chicago. Partly cloudy in most other parts of the east. Sunshine in Foxborough. In the rest of the country, expect thunderstorms in Dallas and a little snow in Denver. And in Pasadena on January 2nd, it'll be 80 degrees and sunny, and my Oregon Ducks will play Penn State in the Rose Bowl. Greg?
Oregon didn't go into the Rose Bowl duck tail first yesterday, did they?
Ha, 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 quack power.
Congratulations. Let's turn our attention to Will McDonough, who's in Foxborough with the latest NFL news and notes, beginning with the change in the coaching job in Houston. Hello, Will.
Hey, Greg, how you doing? Quack power? I mean, what is that stuff all about? Let's talk about Houston. Last week, they fired Jack Prady, and they named Jeff Fisher, the defensive coordinator, to be the new head coach. However, before they did that, they called Joe Bugle, the former head coach of the Arizona Cardinals, and asked him if he would like to be the assistant head coach with Fisher. Joe Bugle turned it down because he thinks he can still get a head coaching job at the end of the year in the NFL. However, we did talk to Houston, and they say the three-year contract that Fisher has can be voided at the end of the year either by owner Bud Adams or by Fisher himself. In Atlanta, Andre Rison was suspended this week, and here's why. Andre had been late for about 20 meetings this year, and early in the week, June Jones, the head coach, said, "We don't want you to be late for another one." So Andre responded by being late the next day. That's why he's suspended and will not play for the Falcons today. The Cleveland Browns defense ranks 15th statistically in the league, but they're a lot better than that. In the most important category, fewest points, they're number one with just 118 points given up. Watch the Browns today when they play Kansas City defensively. Bill Belichick, the head coach in Cleveland, has a history of playing well against the so-called West Coast offense. This is a San Francisco 49ers style of offense, and Kansas City plays it, Green Bay plays it. The last four times he's coached against this type of offense, he has given up just a total of 39 points. And the way they play this offense is they attack the quarterback, and they will attack Joe Montana today. Tony Dungy of the Minnesota Vikings gave his defensive team an extra day off this week, and the reason? They were exhausted for chasing Drew Bledsoe around here last week 70 times. 70 wind sprints trying to chase him down during that record-breaking performance. Dungy says, even though they never sacked Bledsoe in the game, they knocked him down 19 times. Now, the Patriots play San Diego here today. They're concerned about the great pass rush of the Chargers, but they're more concerned about their own ability to stop the San Diego running games, what Natron means. There's a big difference in the size between the Charger offensive line and the smaller Patriot defensive front. Greg?
All right, well, thank you. Let's go back to this Andre Rison situation, Mike. Late for meetings 20 times. What took them so long to react?
Well, it's way overdue, and the reason they didn't react sooner is because he is who he is. But my coach of the year is Don Nelson, because the inmates cannot run the asylum.
Is this the right decision in Atlanta? It must be.
Well, I think it is. Coaches don't mind wild personalities. I had some kooky guys myself. Dexter, you know, John Riggins and people like that. But what a coach does not want on his football team is somebody's going to challenge the rules. In this case, he was given an ultimatum. The next day he challenged the coach. He's trying to make a statement. Sometimes I think the statement is, how long am I going to stay in this league?
Fortunately, we have no kooky personalities here.
Well,
back with our picks of the week in a moment.
People care these days. They just don't want me to put another toxic antifreeze in their car. I mean, who needs something that toxic? So what if it protects to 70 below? Any antifreeze can do that. Give me something different. Something safer that's essentially non-toxic. I mean, what if their dog gets into it? for their kids. This is serious.
Sierra, it's not just antifreeze, it's safety freeze.
Nice painting. What is it?
Not a very interesting piece. Reminiscent of early Dadaism.
What's Dadaism?
If he's so smart, why is he using those other batteries?
With a brain that big, you'd think he'd know Duracell batteries outlast all other brands.
Now, if...
You're right, Mom. The museum can be fun.
The Copper Top. Tops them all.
Hi, Tom Baudet from Motel 6 with some insight for the traveler. Well, this is what one of our rooms looks like when you're sleeping. And you know, it looks just like those big fancy hotels. Only difference is ours won't cost you nearly as much money. In fact, Motel 6 always has the lowest prices of any national chain on a clean, comfortable room. Makes you sleepy just looking at it. Well, I'm Tom Baudet from Motel 6, and we'll leave the light on for you.
Panasonic camcorder tapes play in your VHS recorder. Not all camcorders can do that. If anyone tells you that's not important, they're giving you a snow job. Get the Panasonic camcorder camcorder or take your chances.
Panasonic, just slightly ahead of our time.
Fasten your seatbelts. Yeah!
Because 94 Fleer Ultra Football has more goals, more photos, and more incredible inserts featuring superstars and hot rookies. There's one insert card in every pack. Fleer Ultra, better than ever.
The Pick of the Week is brought to you by American Honda, who has been making quality cars in America for the past 12 years. There were no winners last week. Greg Gumbel has a half-game lead. We'll have this week's picks right after this message from Honda.
Ever wonder what bears really do in the woods? The Passport from Honda.
6 weeks left in the regular season. Tight race going in the picks. Today, Will likes the Vikings over the Jets. Joe Gibbs thinks Buffalo plays big when they have to. Mike Ditka is going the other way. Packers over the Bills. Ahmad is picking San Diego over New England by the same score. His Oregon Ducks won yesterday, 17-13. I'll go with Jeff Blake and the Bengals over the Colts. And in honor of the Oregon Ducks going to the Rose Bowl, we would like you, Ahmad, to have this. And we'd also like you to know that for Penn State versus Oregon in the Rose Bowl, Joe, you're going to go with who?
Penn State.
Mike?
Penn State.
Will picks Penn State. I'm going to go with Penn State.
Fight on, Oregon Ducks. And I would sing the fight song if I knew it. But I will know it by January 2nd.
Or at least by halftime. We will see you at halftime. Scores and highlights. We hope you enjoy the day.
You guys didn't even give it a shot.
Journey into the unknown. 2 hours of the greatest adventure on TV, Earth 2, followed by Sequence at 7, 6 Central, NBC Sundays.
This is your two-minute warning for the end of the 94 model year. Final clearance of 94 Oldsmobile Supreme, Sierras, 88s and 98s, is going on right now at your nearby Olds retailer. There's a big demand for your trade-in, and with 95s arriving daily, you may never see Oldsmobile prices this low again. So now's the time to catch big savings on your new Oldsmobile. I got mine. Get yours today during the end of the model year clearance at your Heart of America Oldsmobile retailer.
Thinking about getting a pizza? Yeah, but hey, don't get up. Call Pizza Hut. We deliver everything you crave. Irresistible Pizza Hut pizza, loaded with any of our mouth-watering toppings, your favorite garden vegetables, or perfect pieces of pepperoni, all dripping with our hot, delicious cheese. We've got the pizza you want, the way you want it, delivered right to your door.
And now, for the ultimate delivery, get a medium specialty pizza and a medium one-topping pizza delivered for just $12.99. Call Pizza Hut Delivery today.
It's the best news of the year, and only your Ford dealer has it. Now drive America's best-selling sedan or wagon, Ford Taurus, for the same low lease payment. Only $249 a month for just 24 months. That's right, sedan or wagon, just $249 a month. Or buy any new Ford Taurus with 2.9 financing or $750 cash back. Lease a sedan or wagon, just $249 a month for 24 months. Buy any new Taurus with 2.9 financing or $750 cash back. It's Ford's best offer of the year on America's best-selling car, Ford Taurus. An offer like this won't last. See your Ford dealer today.
KSHB 41. We're NBC.
It's a 46-degree rainy day, a driving rain. The forecast calling for more of this throughout the day here at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City as we get ready for the Cleveland Browns and the Kansas City Chiefs. Cleveland and San Diego with the best records in the AFC at 8-2, Miami and Pittsburgh at 7-3. Kansas City vying for a playoff berth at 6-up and 4-down. But the sputtering Chiefs saw time run out on them last week in their one-point loss to the Chargers. Joe Montana and his Chiefs have dropped two of their last three games, while the Cleveland Browns, with a solid performance at the Vet in Philadelphia, defeated the Eagles 26-7 to make it seven wins in their last eight games. Hi, everybody. Marv Albert, along with Paul McGuire. Well, it will be Mark Rippon at quarterback for the Browns. Vinny Testaverde, coming back from the concussion, will be available, but Rippon the starter. And, Paul, this a Cleveland team that is based on ball control, very physical defense, and spectacular special teams play.
What a great special teams they have. With Eric Metcalf returning punts and Randy Baldwin, who leads the National Football League with an average of 30 yards per return, they give Mark Rippon and the Cleveland Browns their best field position they've ever had. And when I talked to Rippon the other day, he said, hey, look, it's easy to play offense when they give you this kind of field position. Marv?
And Cleveland going up against a injury-hit Kansas City team. Seven starters among the missing. Randy Baldwin, Eric Metcalf are back deep. Cleveland winning the toss and receiving the kickoff. Here is Metcalf. Out across the 25 and taken down at the 29-yard line. An 18-yard return by Metcalf. A look at the injury list and a very impressive list of players.
Well, one guy big on defense is Neil Smith, because the Cleveland Browns, when you're talking about him, when you play the Chiefs, you worry about Derek Thomas and Neil Smith. Now Smith is gone, they can concentrate all their offensive energies on Derek Thomas.
Marty Schottenheimer telling us, although he does not want to use injuries as an excuse, it is the worst that a Schottenheimer team has ever suffered in terms of injuries. The Browns starting out at their 29-yard line. And the handoff goes to Leroy Horde. Leroy Horde has been a revitalized player the past several weeks as he's taken over for the injured Tommy Vardell. A look at the Cleveland offense up front: Tony Jones, Doug Dawson, Steve Everett, Bob Dahl, and the 6'7", 325-pound Orlando Brown now at right tackle, making his third straight start. Rippon the quarterback, Metcalf and Horde the running backs. Derek Alexander back from the ankle problem. Mark Carrier, Brian Kinkin, the other receivers. And Michael Jackson, who made his return from the hamstring injury last week, is available as the third wideout. A second down and six. Metcalf looked like he stumbled momentarily on the turf. It is a very muddy field, and he was met by the middle linebacker, Tracy Simeon. Kansas City up front, Pella McDaniels for the injured Neil Smith. Smith, remember, leads the AFC with 11 and a half sacks. Phillips, Saliamoa, and Mikkel up front on that Kansas City defensive line. Derek Thomas with seven sacks. Tracy Simeon, George Jamison are the linebackers. Jay Taylor for the injured Mark Collins. And Charles Vincey for the injured David Whitmore. When they go to the nickel, Darren Anderson and Doug Terry check in. And there is Neil Smith watching in the rain on the sideline. It's a third down and four. And a big hole for Ernest Biner. And he has a first down run out by the right corner, Dale Carter. And Paul, this weather made to order for the Cleveland Browns style of pounding the football.
And the thing that they did last time is this last play is they ran right at Derek Thomas. Look at Derek Thomas, 58. Watch him come upfield. They just turn him out. Once they turn him out, they sealed inside, and Biner gets downfield for the first down. They're going to run at Thomas.
So a first down at the 44-yard line. Bill Belichick, who has done an excellent job. Now things have turned around from last season when he was involved in the Bernie Kosar
controversy. He didn't remind his team during the course of the week. As you see Hoare take it, he reminded his team that, hey, we're 8-2, but there's a long way to go. Last year, Miami was 9-2 and then lost 5 straight, did not make the playoffs. He mentioned the 1986 New York Jets, who opened at 10-1, and then they staggered into the playoffs while losing their last 5 games.
But he still didn't tell you who was the quarterback.
Yes, he would not reveal, but we had our ways, Paul.
Yeah, I know. We got it out of Leroy Hort.
And now you're going to get Bill Belichick annoyed.
No, Leroy Hort. Well, Leroy was just trying to help himself.
You kind of tricked him into it. Yeah.
You did. I didn't.
Second down and 7. Off the play action, Rippon throws a bullet behind Metcalf. And it brings up a 3rd and 7.
Well, Rippon didn't have to throw the ball that hard. Metcalf was open. And he not only threw it hard, but he threw it behind him. He didn't have a chance to catch the ball.
Last week, after the impressive road victory over the Eagles, Bill Belichick gave every player a game ball because he felt that everyone contributed.
You know, it's nice that when you can give a game ball to 50 or 46 players and it doesn't come out of your pocket.
Oh, yes. He did say that the president and owner of the Browns, Art Modell, would be delighted to handle the bill. You saw the tight end Kinchin stumble. And Rippon goes deep. And the catch made by Mark, incomplete. Mark Carrier, the intended receiver. He was covered by Jay Taylor.
Doug Terry was coming on a blitz, and the Cleveland Browns, in their offensive line, did they pick this thing up. Watch the blocking. Rippon has all the time he wants to throw the football. The ball is thrown short to the outside. Excellent coverage on the defensive side of the field, but they did have great blocking up front. Jay Taylor was there on Carrier, but the blocking was super.
And the punting unit checking in. Tom Tupa will punt to Dale Carter. Carter back at his 10-yard line. And it is down around the 20. 33-yard punt by Tupa. We'll be right back.
Listen, this stuff that we make, it's powerful. It makes you powerful. Take it. Gather up your ideas. Listen. This stuff, run with it. Listen, it's powerful. This stuff that you think, it's powerful. This stuff that make trouble and good things. Gather up your ideas. Make some mistakes. Just do something amazing. It makes you powerful. This stuff that you think, take it. Gather up your ideas. Do something amazing. Gather up your ideas. Find something good. We're in your corner. Listen. We can't wait to see what you're going to do. Listen. Listen. Listen.
Chevy was the first to give full-size pickups an independent front suspension. Because the last thing we'd want to do is spill this guy's coffee.
Well, it's been an up and down season for Joe Montana, who, of course, hasn't been helped by all the Kansas City injuries. We talked with Michael Dean Perry of the Browns and asked, what is the game plan against Montana?
I think what we have to do today is put pressure on Montana early and put pressure on him up the middle, because he likes to step up and throw the ball so he can have the whole field to see. And if he can't step up and we hit him early, I don't care what you have seen in the past for 16 years, nobody likes to get hit. And so we have to get to him early.
Yes, they will look to rattle Montana early in the game. First play, though, goes to Kimball Anders, and he was stopped by the outside linebacker, Frank Stams. A look at the Kansas City offensive line. Derek Graham at the all-important left tackle position for the injured John Ault, bothered by a back problem, so Ricky Sigler is back as a starter at right tackle. The quarterback is Montana, Greg Hill for Marcus Allen, along with Kimball Anders in the backfield. Martin, Dawson, and Walker, the receivers. Hughes comes in when they go three wide. Willie Davis, as you saw earlier, also sitting it out. Again, it's to the ground. It's Greg Hill, the rookie out of Texas A&M. A look at the Cleveland defensive line. They've played very well. Burnett, Johnson, Perry with two sacks last week, showing some signs coming along. Two sacks against the Eagles. Pleasant, the right defensive end. The linebackers, Banks, Pepper, Johnson, who leads the Browns in total tackles, and Stams, Langham, and Griffin at the corners. Griffin, a one-time 49er teammate of Montana. Moore and Turner are the deep men. Jacobs and Caldwell come in the nickel package. It's a third down and three at the 27-yard line. Montana off the roll and completes at the first down marker to the tight end. Derek Walker looks to be a drop short of the first down.
You know they're not going to try and go deep. They're just going to try to throw the ball out. This is Montana style. Let's pick up, get the short pass, and let the receiver try to run for the first down. That time it didn't work. Defense played very well.
So Metcalf and Carrier are back deep as Louis Aguiar comes on to punt for the first time. He's back at his 15. Last week, Aguiar tied a Kansas City franchise record with 11 punts against the Chargers.
That's one of those records you don't want to have.
And Aguiar with a short punt. Well, he did prevent a return, and it was blocked. Recovered by the Chiefs.
That's a bad call because Carrier is down. They've got to overturn this call. Carrier was down. Someone was on his back when he was on the ground, and he fumbled the ball. This will not stand up. It shouldn't. When the man is down on the ground cannot cause a fumble. Remember that. It is Cleveland Browns' ball. It's got to be.
And apparently that is the call because the Browns are very happy and heading back to their sideline after the brief discussion with the officials. And let's get the official word from Howard Rowe. And apparently the audio affected by the rain.
Well, what he said was down by contact, and that's the thing. Carrier does the right thing. He doesn't let the ball roll. Now watch. He is on when he catches the ball, he's down. Now he's on the ground. When he's on the ground down, now he gets hit. When you're down, the ground can't cause a fumble. This is an excellent call.
So the Browns maintain possession and start out from their 35-yard line. As Leroy Hoard driven back, a loss on the play. Leroy Hoard, who comes in averaging 4.7 yards per carry, that is second in terms of average to Barry Sanders of Detroit. Last week, 86 yards on 21 carries against the Eagles.
And I like the things he was saying to us yesterday, that you know that he came in, he took a cut in pay. They actually cut him, then they brought him back with less money. And he said, he came into camp in the best shape he's ever been in. He said, they're gonna have to give me a reason to cut me.
All right, the draw for Horn. And he gets to the 39, met by the outside linebacker, George Jamison. Bill Belichick saying that both Ford and Baldwin, who were cut and then re-signed, came back with more maturity, a bit more humble. And also, both took cuts in pay.
Yeah, you know, they did. But, you know, when you look at Baldwin, what he has done, he is the only player in the National Football League on kickoff returns that is averaging 30 yards or better in the entire National Football League. That's terrific.
It's a third and six from the 39. Hoard, the lone deep back. And Rippon pops it out to the tight end, Kinchin. And he dives to the 45. We'll have to see where they spot the ball. It's covered up by Carter. needed the 45 for a first down.
Well, the one marker is on the other side of the 45. He may be about the nose of the ball short on this thing, but you have a great defensive football team. You're at the 45-yard line. The offense knows where they're going. The field is slippery. I think you go for it.
8:38 remaining in the first quarter. The Chiefs and the Browns are scoreless. Second possession for Cleveland. Kansas City had one, and it is short of a first down.
It's just, the ball, and this is a big decision for Belichick. And I think you go for it. I mean, you've got a strong defensive football team. You have a muddy field again. There isn't much traction. And the offense, again, they know where they're going to put the ball. You've got a big quarterback like Griffin. And don't make any mistakes. Lock up, touch the center, and go.
And the decision is to go for it. Jones, Dawson, Everett, Dahl, and Brown up front. Apparently a timeout being indicated.
Well, the Chiefs can't get the right combination on defense on the field.
Kansas City forced to take a timeout. There was some confusion in terms of the alignment.
When we developed our new advanced handling and driver control system, we looked to Lexus and BMW. But we didn't stop there. Introducing the all-new Chevy Blazer. With the exclusive driver control system. Even if you never take it this far, it's nice to know it's there.
Most people would jump at the chance. 10 days in South America. If this was business, and I was 5,000 miles from home, trying to keep my bearings, trying to negotiate, sometimes just trying to communicate, all the while hoping to pull this whole thing off so I could head back.
Yeah, I'm gonna be another day.
You know, it's funny, being away so long. When you come across something familiar,
going home, Mr. Reynolds,
it can be a pretty welcome sight.
I'm halfway there.
What if I told you everything you know about TV is about to change? Because now, there's DirecTV, totally digital television. More movies, more sports, more of what I want than ever before. All through a tiny satellite dish about the size of a small pet.
Stay. With digital quality video and CD sound,
everything's gonna look great.
How does DirecTV work? I have no idea.
But it does. Get your DSS 18-inch dish and DirecTV at your RCA dealer.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Microsoft. Where do you want to go today? By Beechwood H. Budweiser. It's always been true, this Bud's for you. By the all-new Chevy Blazer. Test drive it at your local Chevy dealer. And by DirecTV, introducing personalized TV.
Well, Kansas City had to burn an early timeout last week. They took a timeout in the third quarter that cost them down the stretch. Bill Belichick, during the course of that timeout, sent the punting unit onto the field and then either tried to confuse the Chiefs even more so or changed his mind because they are going for it.
Well, he had the punting unit out there and the offense out there. Yes. And the punting unit just left, and now Riffin, maybe they're going to try and drop off. Oh, they moved.
And the flags come flying. Riffin trying to get the Chiefs to jump.
Well, they did throw a flag.
Obviously, the microphone on the referee, Howard Rowe, is not working. So the call against the Browns.
I think it's Bob Dahl, number 72. It'll be a right guard to be right in here that they're going to move. And once he moves across the line, once you're set, you've got to stay set. Keep your eye right there. There he moves.
And now the punting unit has come out. That's Tom Tupa in his sixth year out of Ohio State, punting for the second time. Dale Carter, averaging about 8 yards per return, is back at his eight. No score with 8.5 remaining in this first quarter. Beautiful punt by Tupa. And here's Carter going wide out to the 25. Penalty flag is dropped. Nice return by Carter. Run out just inside the 40 by the punter. Tupa, 44-yard punt and a 20-yard return, but let's check out the penalty.
Hey, the guy that's got his head down is Ron Dickerson. And he was the guy that hit the punter a week ago. And this may be against number 23. Would have to read lips to get it. Number 23. Pushing it back. Here it is. Watch his lips.
Yes, illegal block in the back.
By number 23.
Okay. Appears to be on Dickerson. We'll be back in Kansas City in a moment.
On a day like this, you're bound to see quite a few great performances on the ice. But few are as gripping as the Lumina minivan. Its available traction control system keeps you sure-footed even in the worst weather. Lumina. It looks different because it is different.
Here's a toughie. Which is better, one supreme pizza for $10.99 or two for $9.98 at Little Caesars? Brilliant. Why get one supreme pizza when you can get two at Little Caesars for just $9.98?
Pizza, pizza.
Thanks to an exclusive 8.4-volt power pack, the Black & Decker Ranger gives you all the power you need to finish any little project, like a deck. The Black & Decker Ranger. Finish what you start.
A taste you'll find in no other beer at any price. Beechwood Aged Budweiser.
It's always been true.
Journey into the unknown. 2 hours of the greatest adventure on TV. Earth 2, followed by Sequest at 7, 6 Central, NBC Tonight.
Monday, find out what the Fresh Prince did.
Jay Leno is suing me for $10 million.
To tick off Jay Leno.
Who's our next guest?
The all new Fresh Prince, NBC Monday.
Joe Montana ranked number 3 in career completions and climbing coming into today's game.
However, this area, he loves to throw the ball. Here he comes.
And he swings it out. Able to connect with Lake Dawson. Frank Stams on the stop. Let's check in with Greg Gumbel for this update.
All right, Marv, at Foxborough, the Patriots are on the board against San Diego. Drew Bledsoe threw 70 times last week. Gets a 28-yard touchdown pass here. Leroy Thompson scores with the extra point. The Patriots lead the Chargers 7-0 in the first quarter, Marv.
All right, Greg, a second down and 4 at the 16-yard line. 8 minutes remaining in this first quarter. Eric Turner making the stop on Kimball Anders. And it's a first down for Kansas City.
The blocking up front, and this is where it's going to be critical. And when you look right in this area in here, they're going to try to move out Michael Dean Perry out of the middle and also Bill Johnson, number 94. And this is where they make the block. Frank Stams gets blocked. You know, Bill Johnson, when you're talking about him playing today, the only two losses the Browns have is when he has not played.
And a first down at the 23-yard line. A short pickup by Donnell Bennett, the rookie from Miami, a second-round draft pick. Went for two on the play.
Well, they are exchanging everybody in this game. Here it is, Bennett up there, Michael Dean Perry making a hit at the line of scrimmage. He doesn't make the tackle. But they're interchanging an awful lot of people.
Donnell Bennett in the backfield now, carrying the ball for only the 16th time. A very strong physical inside runner. A second down and 8 at the 25-yard line. 6:45 remaining in this first quarter. Montana off the roll. Fumble, fumbled it. And it is recovered. Combination of Will Shields, the right guard, and Joe Montana. Very difficult conditions. And the Kansas City Chiefs have certainly had their problems in the rain, in the mud here
at Arrowhead, they have gone 0-2 under these circumstances.
All right, here comes Bill Johnson upfield, and watch, he pulls Montana's hand away. Rob Burnett is also upfield with him, but this is that defensive line. They want to pursue. They want to get right in Montana's face. And if you notice, Montana's doing more rollouts now than he ever did before.
Bill Johnson gets credit for a sack, a third down, and 16. And the pass incomplete, intended for the tight end, Derek Walker.
Derek Walker looked like he wasn't even looking. Montana's going to come up and throw the ball to the outside. He is looking at only one person, Walker. Look at this. Walker just pulls away, pulls his hands down. He really doesn't have a chance. We look at Montana after the throw. He's like, come on, what are you doing?
So Louis Aguiar coming in to punt from inside his five. Again, both Metcalf and Carrier are back, this because of the poor field conditions. Good kick. And a play by Carrier. Mark Carrier broke a tackle, being chased by Aguiar. Carrier down to the 20. Mark Carrier is hit out of bounds at the 6.
You know, I'm going to tell you some special teams. We talked about this. This is what they do. We talked about Metcalf and we talked about Baldwin. But you know who gets the best block? It's Eric Metcalf, number 21. Here he is. Watch what he does. Here he comes. Here, watch Metcalf. Watch the block that he gets. He comes across. That's Dickerson, and bam, he is on the ground. Now, this is where the special teams take over. Now you got to add to Metcalf and Baldwin. Let's add Carrier. And I'm going to tell you something else. The player's going to laugh him down because he gets caught by Aguiar, the punter.
Yes.
They'll run this back about 100 times in the special teams meeting.
49-yard punt and a 60-yard return for Mark Carrier. First and goal at the 6-yard line. Ward with a short pickup. Derek Thomas on the tackle. As we keep telling you, they are the best special teams unit in the National Football League.
Well, one of the reasons that Carrier's back there because of his speed and also with Metcalf is they have, on a rainy day like this, they call the good hands people. They want these guys in the ball game. But you see all the blocking, and Carrier sets up most of them, and then Aguiar actually saves this touchdown.
It is a second and goal at the 5. Ford, the lone deep back, Metcalf in motion. Griffin looking that way. Griffin, incomplete. Charles Mincy on the coverage of Eric Metcalf.
Remember what he said yesterday to us when you're talking about Griffin. He said, you know, it's so easy. Here comes Metcalf. Now I'll get back to this in a second. He's I don't know if he's the main target or not because the ball is over. He's being pulled down. But when we're talking to Griffin, he said, how easy is it when you get the ball in great field position because of the special teams? And here's a classic example of it. And they want 7.
Third and goal at the 5. 5 minutes remaining in a scoreless first quarter. And it's fumbled by Griffin, recovered by the Chiefs. The middle linebacker, Tracy Simeon, comes up with the ball.
It really looked like the ball might have been centered early. And they didn't have the snap count. You can't make mistakes down here. Steve Everett, number 61, is the center. Griffin is underneath the center, and watch everybody if they're moving. You see that? Hold on. He was not ready. It looked like it was centered early.
So the Chiefs will take over deep in their territory.
Wendy's celebrates 25 years of being the best in the business. In 1978, the Giants led the Eagles by 5 in the final seconds and needed to simply run out the clock for a victory. Do you remember which Eagle helped produce a miracle?
Dave, so nice to have you here.
Nice being here.
Appetizer, sir.
They brought them in from Madagascar.
Did they bring any more?
Look, tete de veau.
Oh, boy. I think I'm going to Wendy's.
When you're really hungry, try Wendy's Big Bacon Classic Combo. A quarter pound of fresh beef, bacon, cheese, lots of toppings, plus Biggie fries and a 20-ounce drink.
Now, that's a delicious meal.
Just in time for dessert.
Every tete de veau. Who's got room for dessert?
Right, right, Obie.
Try Wendy's Big Bacon Classic Combo.
Herman Edwards' shocking fumble recovery produced the winning score in the miracle of the Meadowlands.
It's picked up by Herman Edwards. I don't believe it. 10, 5, touchdown Eagles.
Another great football moment from the past 25 years.
The man in black is back. For an unsurpassed seventh time. Chevrolet congratulates Dale Earnhardt and the Childress Good Ranch Chevrolet Racing Team on capturing the 1994 NASCAR Drivers' Championship. One car company has won more races in the history of NASCAR. That's genuine Chevrolet.
Nothing's more American on Thanksgiving Day than the NFL on NBC. Buffalo battles Detroit as two great running backs, Thurman Thomas of the Bills and Barry Sanders of the Lions, go head-to-head. A Thanksgiving Day tradition at a special time, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific.
A football feast, Thanksgiving Day on NBC.
Now, folks, look at the whole picture, but watch, keep in mind, these two guys and these two guys, watch when the ball snapped. They don't move at all. Watch. See it? Now they move. Griffin was looking someplace else. Everett centered the ball early.
And the Chiefs start out from their 6-yard line. And they go to the ground, but a penalty marker is down as Greg Hill got the call. Frank Stans on the tackle. Kansas City trying to establish a running game that has not done well. 17th in the league. They average only 98 yards a game.
Offsides, number 98 defense. Lined up in the line of over the line of scrimmage, 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Neutral zone. They're trying to neutral zone. But if you take a look at the Chiefs' three drives, they start at their own 20, their own 10, and their own 6. They're glad to start at their own 6 on this one here because they recovered the fumble.
And the Kansas City Chiefs coming into today leading the NFL with 18 fumble recoveries. Tracy Simeon coming up with number 19. It's a first down and 5 at the 12. And Montana able to complete out at the 25-yard line. Lake Dawson, the rookie from Notre Dame, with a 15-yard gain. He was brought down by the strong safety, Stevon Moore.
Boy, you talk about, you know, they're hurting in the offensive line. They're hurting everywhere. Watch along in here, folks. You're going to see this offensive line. Look at the protection that Montana has. And now you see Dawson. He just sets into that zone. He's wide open. Stevon Moore is trying to cover it. They release into the zone. See the zone? With all that time, Montana has a chance to find Lake Dawson.
First down at the 27-yard line. 4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Again, Montana able to complete. This time connects with Chris Penn. Penn, the rookie from Tulsa. So Marty Schottenheimer doing a lot of shuffling here in the early going. Well, with all the injuries that have been suffered, J.J. Burden, question mark because of a back problem, has been in there, but he's been going with 5 receivers.
Now, that looked like man-to-man because Don Griffin, number 28, was on Penn coming all the way across, so they were in a man-to-man. You know, it's different. You look at Kansas City, they'll throw the ball. Look at Cleveland. They don't want to throw the ball.
Chiefs have a second and 4 from their 33. And it is back to the ground. Donnell Bennett getting his second carry of the day. Pepperd Johnson made the stop close to the first down. Let's go to Greg Gumbel for this update.
All right, Marv, in Cincinnati, a Bengals first quarter turnover proved costly. The Colts recovered, drove Marshall Faulk from a yard out, his AFC leading 11th touchdown. The Colts are leading the Bengals 7-0 late in the first, Marv.
All right, Greg. Cincinnati has become an interesting scenario with Jeff Blake taking over at quarterback and has really gotten things going. It is a first down for Kansas City. First down at the 38-yard line. 2:45 in the first quarter. The surge by Bennett. Bennett accelerating. Stopped by Frank Stans. A short pickup. Carl Banks also involved on the tackle. A reminder, this Thursday, Thanksgiving night at 8, 7 Central, a comedy hit and a new holiday tradition. Macaulay Culkin stars in Home Alone. And then Jerry Seinfeld salutes one of the great comedy teams of all time, Abbott and Costello. You'll see outtakes and home movies and their best bits, including one of your favorite, Paul.
Who's on first?
Yes, that's right. Jerry Seinfeld beating Abbott and Costello. An end around for Dawson. And he's tackled at the 43 by Pepper Johnson. Pepper Johnson, who signed as a free agent with the Browns last season after he was cut by the Giants, a mainstay with the Giants for 7 years.
On a wet field, this play just takes too long to develop. Watch this. It is an end around. And here comes Lake Dawson, which, you know, reverses I don't like. But Pepper Johnson makes the play. He is upfield, makes the stop for about a one-yard gain.
I didn't know that. You don't like reverses.
No, I don't like them. Under any circumstances, thank you.
It's a third down and four at the 44. Off the play action. Looks to be some confusion.
Well, I'll tell you the confusion. The confusion is the number 58, Carl Banks, was in Montana's face, and you know who was covering on the outside? Michael Dean Perry was covering on Bennett. I mean, it is unbelievable. Michael Dean Perry, they run a blitz with Carl Banks, and he gets in the face to the right of the screen. Now watch where number 92 ends up. See Bennett coming out? Oh, no, that's Kimball Landers. Excuse me, Kimball Landers coming out? Covered by the versatile Michael Dean Perry.
So, Louis Aguiar is back to punt. The last punt returned 60 yards by Carrier. Here he comes again. And this time he's well covered. Stopped as he crossed the 20. A 41-yard punt and a 6-yard return. So the Browns will start out from their 21-yard line. Well, Thanksgiving Day, this coming Thursday, NBC Sports with a very fine-looking matchup for you, starting with NFL Live at the special time of 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Buffalo and Detroit matching two of the NFL's best running backs, Thurman Thomas of the Bills and Barry Sanders of the Lions. Buffalo and Detroit, Thanksgiving Day, starting with NFL Live at the special time of 12 noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, right here on NBC. Bills in front of Green Bay today, 14-0, trying to bounce back.
Well, they're a team. You just don't know which team's going to show up.
Mark Griffin at quarterback for the Cleveland Browns. We come up on a minute remaining in the first quarter. Metcalf, the intended receiver. It will be a second down and 10. This is the best start in nearly 30 years for the Browns. The last time the Browns started this well, 1965, when they won 10 of the first 12 and finished the season at 11-3, but they lost the NFL championship game at Green Bay. The Browns have won 7 of their last 8. They come in at 8-2, one game in front of 7-3 Pittsburgh in the AFC Central. Play action. And Rippon, incomplete again, intended for Metcalf.
That ball just floated on him. But the one thing you do, I like what they're doing now. Throw the ball in the rain. The offense, you know where you're going to go. The receivers can make cuts, can do a lot of things. And the defense, on that last play, Keenan McCardle, number 87, was downfield all by himself. But Rippon chose to throw the ball to Metcalf.
Mark Rippon, a player who went from Super Bowl most valuable player with the Redskins in 92 to the bench in a very short time. He turned down a major cut in salary, released, signed with Cleveland last May. There were some reports that his arm was shot, skills were questioned, but he told us yesterday that he knew he could play. He's done a nice job the last 2 weeks, but having his problems here, that pass intended for Derek Alexander. So Rippon is now 1 for 7.
I mean, he's just throwing bad passes. Now, I know the ball is wet, and the ball is coming out slippery from the center, but he is really throwing bad passes. And another thing I'm watching here, too, is the offensive line and the tight end. They're just picking up Derek Thomas. They're having two people. They're chipping him first and then let the lineman take him.
This figures to be a very busy day for the two punters, Aguiar and Tupa. Here's Tupa for the third time with Carter back at his 40. Carter let it bounce, and it is slapped out of bounds around the 40-yard line by Benny Thompson. A 39-yard punt. So it will be a first and 10 from the 41-yard line. Marty Schottenheimer, one-time head man of the Cleveland Browns,
faced the team he used to coach on three previous occasions. Only three Browns remaining from the Schottenheimer era. Ernest Biner, who went to Washington, then came back. Tony Jones and Michael Dean Perry. Schottenheimer against the Browns is one win, one loss, and one tie. Montana off play action. Montana with the completion to Greg Hill.
You talk about composure. You talk about knowing where every single player is on the field. Now Frank Stams is down, number 50 for Cleveland, the linebacker. But Montana, I mean, the pressure's on. He just knows where people are. Just watch what he does. Play action. There's the fake. Now, he's going to find Hill because he knows Hill's sitting over there. Watch this. Turns around before he's hit, gets the ball to Hill. They pick up 8.5 yards on the play. You talk about knowing where you are and where everyone else is. Boom.
Down to 25 seconds to go in this first quarter. Joe Montana, 5 for 7 here in the early going for 37 yards. And they're still checking out the linebacker, Frank Stams. For the Kansas City Chiefs, who come in at 6-4, it has been a roller coaster season. They won their first three, lost two, then won two. They've lost two of the last three. And check this out, of the six wins, they've averaged just under 24 points per game, 399 yards per game average. And in the four losses, they've gone the other way. They have not been able to score, and that's been the story in recent weeks.
You know, and you watch them last week against the San Diego Chargers. Now, granted, they were up 13-0 in a couple of plays. Ron Dickerson ran into the punter, and it cost them getting the ball back. They also had a chance. Dale Carter had a chance to pick up a fumble and run for a touchdown. But in the process, Darren Mikkel runs up and whacks him and knocks him off the ball, and San Diego gets it back again. So they've had a lot of problems. But the most important thing, like that graphic crew, they're not moving the football.
And they come in hard hit by injury. Seven starters out of the lineup, four on offense. Key man is the left tackle, John Ault, because of a back problem. So Derek Graham is the starter at left tackle. Back to the ground, and it is a first down for Hill as this first quarter comes to a close. The Chiefs and Browns are scoreless after one here at Arrowhead.
Television of the future? I've got it now. DirecTV. It's movies, hit movies, tons of movies. It's like browsing in a video store right in your living room and always finding what you want. Ooh. The hit movies I want start every 30 minutes. Now, for just $2.99 each, the movies come to me. All digital, so I can get a great picture with CD sound. That never happened before. For more movies, sports, and cable networks, get your DSS 18-inch dish and DirecTV at your RCA dealer.
Imagine a rent-a-car company that will pick you up right at your door. That's Enterprise. Call us. We'll arrange to come to you. Take you back to our office, and you're on your way. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Investing? They'll eat you alive.
You'll never be able to retire.
Your dog knows more about investing than you do.
You'll never get a decent return.
Wake up! You're having that retirement nightmare again. It's awful!
Don't worry. MetLife has preference plus variable annuities. Tax deferred. Easy to understand even for the first-time investor.
Thanks, Linus. I'll look into it in the morning.
Or sooner. Get Met. It pays.
Legendary Eddie Robinson leads his Grambling State Tigers against the Jaguars of Southern University, plus the Battle of the Bands, the Bayou Classic, next Saturday on NBC.
Welcome back to Arrowhead, where, Paul, as you're well aware, this year they made the transfer to natural grass from AstroTurf. You may wonder what happened to the AstroTurf. Well, the Kansas City Chiefs marketing people have put it up for sale. We have a coaster set. Let me check the turf coaster set. $34.95 a piece.
Ooh,
a doormat.
Yeah, hold
yeah sure. Doormat available. Here it is. This is $49.95, all from the old AstroTurf here at Arrowhead.
Talk to me, man. I know where I'm doing my Christmas shopping.
Yes, sure.
Talk to me.
The artificial surface going for better prices, it should be pointed out. First down play,
And Montana completes to Eric Martin as the second quarter gets underway. Stevon Moore on the tackle, but that is good for 12. Eric Martin in his 10th year out of LSU. And over the years as a member of the New Orleans Saints, one of the finest receivers in the National Football League. Here on the coverage by Moore.
Well, what they do is they release here. They release back to Moore on Stevon Moore on the outside, and Montana just hits the open area.
And it's a first down at the Cleveland 34-yard line. The Browns and the Chiefs are scoreless. A penalty marker is thrown, and the play is blown dead.
Derek Walker, the tight end, number 82, left just a tad early.
Prior to the snap, we got a false start on number 82 offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Shouldn't be any problem, you know, here in the count. He's just sitting right in here, and the crowd noise is way down. He just leaves early. A lot early.
It sets it back to a first and 15 at the 39-yard line. Running backs are Greg Hill and Kimball Andrews. Montana making adjustments. And again, a flag is thrown as Montana goes to the sideline. And the ruling is he caught it. Inbounds. Half possession. Eric Martin with a fine play.
There is a flag on the play, though. Back here at the 40. And, you know, you look at the Cleveland guys, and I think they're not too happy. It's
defense,
offside Cleveland.
Number 92 lined up in the neutral zone. Penalty declined. Result of the play, completion for first down.
Martin down the sideline. Now watch, here's the catch. Antonio Langham, is the catch made? Watch the feet. Both feet inbounds. The catch was there. He had the ball. He had control of the ball. Joe's happy.
Just checking it out in the driving rain. And completes for 17 and a first down at the Browns 21-yard line. And back to the ground. Kimball Andrews. Stopped by Mike Caldwell, backup linebacker. There's Caldwell out of Middle Tennessee State. It'll be a second down and 7. This is the third time the last 5 years that the Chiefs have a record of 6-4 after 10 games, but you know that Marty Schottenheimer and general manager Carl Peterson had hoped for much better, but with the moves this franchise had pulled off.
You know, and they went out to get the people to surround Joe Montana, give him the people to throw to. The problem is that they've had so many injuries on this team.
And it is knocked down by the front four of the Browns.
Michael Dean Perry, excuse me, Marvin, is the guy that gets, he's knocked off the line of scrimmage, and he just jumps up and knocks the ball down.
Pass intended for Derek Walker. We were talking with the offensive coordinator of the Chiefs, Paul Hackett, and I said to Paul, how would you categorize the season that Montana has had? And he said the one word, inconsistent. And has struggled the last 3 games, but as we have been mentioning, injuries have certainly had something to do with it. And Paul said that Montana is now healthy, had problems earlier in the season, bruised ribs, injured hip. Third down and 7 from the 18. The swing pass for Andrews. Kimball Andrews with a first down. He's run out. Run out by the right corner, Don Griffin.
What a nice move he makes on Eric Turner, number 29, the free safety. The problem is that Eric Turner didn't get there quick enough. You see 29 right in the middle of your screen? His job is the back. Now watch, he gets a late start, and then Kimball Andrews just a little hitch here, boom, hold him for a second, and he outruns him. First down.
First and goal at the 7. And coming up, the 8th play of the drive. Danelle Bennett now checks into the backfield. Kimball Andrews to the sideline. And Bennett is the lone deep back. This is Bennett into the line and turned back. Michael Dean Perry leading the assault. It'll be a second and goal at the 8. 2.5 minutes gone by in the second quarter. Kansas City and Cleveland are scoreless.
You notice how quiet it is here? Yeah, this is why. Look at over here. There's a sign across from us that says, quiet, please, audible zone.
This is what you call the home field advantage, my friend.
The audible zone.
It's the audible zone.
I believe that's an upcoming show on NBC. On Montana throwing for the... Is it caught? Yes. Lake Dawson.
A short pickup. Pepper Johnson.
He was tackled by Pepper Johnson.
On the stop.
Well, this was not the primary target because Lake Dawson is going to come inside. Pepper Johnson is going to be there. Well, look at Montana. He'll look out to the right. He wanted to get it to Kimball Anders. But Dawson is there. Pepper Johnson, did you see how nice he did that? He went for the ball, but then he put his arms around his waist to make sure of the tackle. I can't knock the ball down. I'm going to knock the player down.
And it is a third and goal at the six-yard line. Now, Dawson is to the right. Montana couldn't find anyone, and then does for the touchdown. It's the tight end, Tracy Green, who is wide open. The rookie from Grambling with his first NFL touchdown, Tracy Green, a seventh-round draft pick.
And he was in blocking, Marv. He was not even considered in the first three receivers. And Montana rolls to the outside. That's the one thing that Michael Dean Perry said, we got to get in his face. They didn't do that, and he'll beat you.
Remember, Tracy Green made that enormous catch in the drive as Montana pulled off the magic in that Monday night game in Denver. The extra point by Lynn Elliott gives Kansas City a 7-0 lead.
I can go from 0 to 60 in 6.9 seconds. I have a thorough disregard for the wind. I have a top track speed of 150 miles per hour. Yet I am very, very quiet. Who am I?
Taco Bell introduces the new Big Fill Menu. Five ways to fill up for under a buck. Three over a half pound, like the fully loaded seven-layer burrito, the hearty Rancho Steak Burrito, and for a limited time, the popular Taco Bell Burrito Supreme, regularly $1.49, is only 99 cents. Five big values. The new Taco Bell Big Fill Menu. It satisfies everything except wimpy appetites. Cross the border.
Thanksgiving Day on NFL Live. We'll talk with former college teammates Thurman Thomas of the Bills and Barry Sanders of the Lions about to face each other on the big day. Plus, Buffalo's defensive superstar Bruce Smith. A special Thanksgiving Day helping of NFL Live. Thursday at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific on NBC.
Cleveland Browns head coach Bill Belichick telling us last night that he might look to ease Vinny Testaverde back into the lineup. Vinny trying to make it back following the concussion, and he may be easing his way in now because Rippon opened up at 1-for-7, and the Browns are trailing the Chiefs 7-0. 10 plays, 59 yards, capped off by the touchdown pass from Montana to Green. Metcalf and Baldwin are back for the kick. And here's Randy Baldwin. He has the speed, and he's taken down across the 35-yard line, a 20-yard return, and it is welcome back, Vinny Testaverde.
Yeah, you know, they don't waste any time. Rippon was not effective at all. Could not get the ball downfield, way off on all of his throws, and go right to Testaverde. Now, if something happens, you can always go back to Rippon again.
Mark Rippon only 1-for-7, 5 yards in this first half. Vinny Testaverde sat out the last two games after suffering a concussion. I medical staff cleared him late in the week. And he's back on the field. Ford trying to go wide, and he's taken down.
All right, let's go back to the touchdown now. On this side over here, right there, there's Green. Now watch, he's in blocking on Burnett. Number 90. He sees Joe in trouble, just slips to the outside. Bang, touchdown. Nice play. Joe's got a new wrinkle in the celebration now. You know, remember the arms up? Now watch this. Let's come in for an airplane landing.
Oh, I like it. Second down and 9. Cleveland only 29 total yards in their 16 plays. Testaverde to throw for the first time and overthrows. Intended for the tight end Frank Hartley, covered by the combination of Simeon and Jameson.
Boy, did he take a shot.
Yes, Hartley shaken up as he slowly makes his way to the sideline. Frank Hartley is a first-year player out of Illinois. Came up with his first NFL catch last week in the game against the Eagles. Up above, the quarterback coach of the Browns, Rod Dauhauer. He was the offensive coordinator for the Washington Redskins under Joe Gibbs. One of the reasons that Mark Griffin said he wanted to sign with the Browns. He worked under Dauhauer in Washington. Testaverde.
He was going to pull it down, Marv, and it slipped out of his hand. Derek Thomas had some heat on him and missed the tackle in the backfield for the sack. That's why he's upset. But Testaverde goes to pull the ball down. These guys are Cleveland. You got to forget about going downfield. Here he comes down. Look at this on the outside. Derek Thomas. He knows he's got Rippon right there. Testaverde right there. But Testaverde, as he goes to throw, he wants to pull the ball down because he sees the defensive people there, and the ball slips out of his hand.
And Tom Tupa has come on to punt from his 23-yard line. Dale Carter is back. High snap. And a line drive. Carter let it bounce. And the Browns will down it. So no return. It's a 45-yard punt. We'll be back at Arrowhead in a moment.
As your engine revs higher, the oil inside creates a hydrodynamic wedge, a protective layer that builds up and keeps engine parts separated. But as your oil's viscosity breaks down, so can the wedge. That's why Castrol GTX provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. Because if your viscosity breaks down, what's next? Castrol GTX, engineered for greater protection against breakdown. Now get a free officially licensed NFL team shirt when you buy a case of Castrol GTX.
It is a world of total confidence. It is Avalon. It is smooth acceleration from a powerful V6 with stability and maneuverability that goes beyond the expected for the most refined ride of any Toyota ever. Avalon, the new flagship from Toyota. Experience the tranquility.
It's only a movie, except on a Sony big screen TV.
Oh, good. Something romantic.
The NFL on NBC is brought to you by Toyota, who invites you to experience the tranquility of the all-new Avalon. By Little Caesars Pizza, where you always get two great pizzas for one low price. By American Airlines, something special in the air. And by the Norelco Razors, our closest shave ever.
And we welcome you back to Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City, Missouri. Marv Albert with Paul McGuire. The Chiefs lead the Browns 7-0. We're early in the second quarter. Kansas City back to the offense, and Montana has a first down, connects with Eric Martin. And he's been using those sidelines in brilliant fashion.
He really has, but the most important thing, he's got all the protection he wants. You know, all is out, but take a look at this. Martin goes down and just turns Antonio Langham around. He doesn't have any idea where he is. Montana has all the time to throw the football, and here it is. Antonio Langham was just totally lost.
14-yard pickup. Montana now 11 of 14, 101 yards. A terrific start for Joe Montana. And a first down at the 32-yard line, Greg Hill. Well, the Kansas City Chiefs in their fifth possession of this half.
But look what they did when they had field position. That's this guy right here. And you get your own 41, you have a chance. The other one's 20, 10, and 6. Give him good field position, you move the ball.
Now Hughes is to the right and Martin to the left. A second down and 8. Kimball Anders with a short pickup. Bill Johnson, the left defensive tackle, and middle linebacker Pepper Johnson involved on that stop, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 7 at the 35-yard line.
Pepper's doing some talking here. Now he's getting mad now. Don't try to run up in here. Pepper's getting trying to get his defense fired up. He's doing fine against the run. It's the pass that's killing him.
And as you mentioned earlier, the Chiefs have struggled in the running game. 3rd and 7. And Montana's pass broken up. Intended for Dawson. And he was covered by Langham.
This is their number 2. He's the number 1 draft pick, but the second guy picked, Antonio Langham, on Lake Dawson. Watch this move. He makes to the inside, goes over the top. Excellent coverage. That is a good play. Pepper Johnson, he is moving back. He's looking in the eyes of Joe Montana. He's just trying to get a piece of it. He moved too far to the outside. He knows if he'd have stayed right where he was, he'd been able to knock the ball down and maybe even catch it.
And here is Louis Aguiar again, punting away to the combination of Metcalf and Carrier. And Carrier muffed it. Excellent coverage by the Chiefs, but it was recovered by the Browns. A 40-yard punt, and the punting game has certainly been on the adventurous side in this first half. Chiefs up 7-0.
It is a world of spaciousness. It is Avalon. Extraordinary comfort that creates a serene environment. Engineering that virtually eliminates noise and vibration, establishing a higher level of elegance than any Toyota ever. Avalon, the new flagship from Toyota. Experience the tranquility.
How much closer do our precision heads help shave beneath the skin? How much closer does our innovative groove make Norelco's lift and cut system? How much better is the latest Norelco razor? Think you'll find it's never brought you closer. The Norelco Razor, our closest shave ever.
One banana or two bananas? One female orangutan or two female orangutans? One supreme pizza for $10.99 or two at Little Caesars for $9.98? He seems to prefer two.
Why settle for one supreme pizza when you can get two at Little Caesars with just $9.98 satisfaction guarantee?
Pizza, pizza.
Nothing's more American on Thanksgiving Day than the NFL on NBC. Buffalo battles Detroit as two great running backs, Thurman Thomas of the Bills and Barry Sanders of the Lions, go head-to-head. A Thanksgiving Day tradition at a special time, noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific.
A football feast, Thanksgiving Day on NBC.
The big problem right here is Metcalf's here. He should be here telling this man not to catch the ball because the guy in the red, Dale Carter, is breathing down his neck. He doesn't make the call.
And the Browns start out from their 23-yard line, and the combination of Rippon and Testaverde are now 1 for 10 for only 5 yards off that incomplete pass intended for Ernest Biner.
Well, Well, you look at their field position, and it has been outstanding. You know, here's this guy right here. There's a 6-yard line and fumbled the football on third down. So they really have not done anything with the ball. I think what's happened is both these quarterbacks, because the ball is a little wet, they're trying to guide the ball instead of stepping back and throw.
Michael Jackson to the left and Derek Alexander to the right. It's Biner. Ernest Biner. Stopped by the right defensive end, Darren Mickle. The Cleveland Browns have accounted for only one first down in this first half, none the last four possessions.
What the Cleveland Browns have to do for their passing game, their running game is going to be fine. But what they have to do with their passing game is to throw a short pass, complete a pass, even if it's a screen. Do something to get some confidence back in the receivers and in the quarterback's arm, because the quarterbacks right now don't have much confidence in themselves.
Third and six at the 27. Diving attempt by Carrier, it is ruled incomplete.
Look where the ball was thrown. Marvin's. First of all, the ball is thrown. Carrier should be on the first down marker, which he's not. Number two, to the left of the screen, you're going to see Testaverde guide the ball out there. Watch this ball. Guide it out. The ball's too far wide. And Carrier, number one, the worst part about it, isn't beyond the first down marker.
So the combination of Rippon and Testaverde, one for 11 for only 5 yards. And it's punt number five for Tom Tupa. Line drives it to Dale Carter. Carter had to pick it up, and he is driven back, still on his feet, and driven back even further, and then looks to get away and stepped out.
But is that kind of retreating a little bit?
So Kansas City will take over.
Another day begins in Europe, and as it does, American Airlines will touch down in 11 European cities in 9 different countries. So whether it's business or pleasure that brings you to Europe, fly the airline that can have you there as early as tomorrow morning. American Airlines, something special to Europe.
Well, look who's here, the gym class joke.
That was before fat-free rolled gold pretzels.
Prove it, pretzel boy.
Must be the pretzels. Wanna dance?
For great taste that's fat-free.
Must be the pretzels.
It must be rolled gold.
Why should you insist on Rebestos brakes? Just ask NASCAR driver Jeff Burton. He drives a race car that travels at speeds up to 200 miles per hour, weighs over 3,000 pounds, and takes an extraordinary set of brakes to stop. But there is one person with even more confidence in Rebestos brakes. Roger. Rebestos, the best in brakes. For the professional installer near you, call 1-800-4-RABESTOS.
Today on NFL Live, Mike Ditka had some harsh words for suspended Falcons receiver Andre Rison.
Well, it's way overdue, and the reason they didn't react sooner is because he is who he is. But my coach of the year is Don Nelson, because the inmates cannot run the asylum.
Tune in to NFL Live next Sunday, 12:30 Eastern, 9:30 Pacific on NBC.
Well, coming up at halftime, Greg Gumbel, Mike Ditka, Joe Gibbs, scores and highlights, and a conversation with Darrell Talley of the Buffalo Bills. From the 16-yard line, Montana starting out. And it is incomplete. Intended for Eric Martin. And on the subject of Greg Gumbel, let's check in for this update.
And a fine subject it is. Marv at Pittsburgh. Dan Marino goes up top to Irving Fryer, who's having a pretty good afternoon so far. This is worth 45 yards. It set up a Marino to Keith Jackson touchdown. And Miami leads Pittsburgh in a battle of 7-3 teams. 7-3, Mark.
All right, Greg, a second and 10 at the 16-yard line back here in Kansas City. That punt by Tupou went 53 yards, and then a minus four on the return for a circling Dale Carter. And now Montana tries to get back, but completes on the screen to Kimball Anders. Don Griffin had it diagnosed that it's a short pickup. Well, Michael Dean Perry telling us, as you heard, that they must put the pressure on early on Joe Montana. And we have been tracking it, and the Browns have not done what they said they'd like to do. No knockdowns, only one sack, and that was a covered sack.
Yeah, well, they said that, and the sack was when they knocked the ball out of Montana's hands and he fumbled the ball, but he's actually not knocked down.
It's a third and six.
Outside defense.
And Montana throws it away.
Frank Stams, who limped off earlier, is now back in the ball game.
Offsides, number 92 defense, 5-yard penalty, repeat third down.
Michael Dean Perry right here. He's just trying to make that big hit, make something happen. We've got to, as he said, we've got to get to Joe Montana. Well, you can't get to him early. Got to wait a little bit. Wait till the ball snap.
So it will be a third down and one at the 25-yard line. Michael Dean Perry alluding to the Bill Belichick philosophy, and over the years as a defensive coordinator with the Giants and also as a head coach of the Browns, Belichick has been very successful with his physical style of play against the 49ers and the San Francisco style of offenses. Anders picks up the first down, but you saw the flag drop once again. And another flag is thrown.
Well, you got one flag against them for holding, but then you might have another flag. I don't know. They threw the flag, and it looked like Caldwell, number 56, was involved in something down there after the first flag went. Here we go. Sort this out, please.
We've got a multiple foul on the offense, holding on the left guard. That penalty's declined. Personal foul, number 87, 15-yard penalty, unnecessary roughness. Repeat third down.
Tracy Green.
Yes, the left guard is Dave Zott, and then Tracy Green was called for the second flag.
You know, you remember, I mean, a lot of times we talk about, you know, the second guy getting caught after the hit. Okay. All right, here's 58. And that's Carl Banks. He pushes him. And now, look at this. Like, oh, I didn't do anything. Carl Banks, I didn't do anything. This guy came after me. Retaliate.
Tracy Green, the tight end, the rookie from Grambling, who caught his first NFL touchdown pass in the first quarter. And the Chiefs, by virtue of that score, have a 0-0 lead. 5:56 to go in the first half. And Kansas City is set back, and it appears they're having difficulties. We were here several weeks ago. They had electrical problems with the scoreboard. It looked like they had the same problem again. Now all has been reset. It's a third and 16 at the 15.
Well, if that's a 15-yard penalty,
no, they've just changed it. Third and 11.
Yeah, well, it's supposed to be an unfortunate conduct. It's a 15-yard penalty.
It's a third and 11 at the 15-yard line. Montana, off the pump, comes up short, intended for J.J. Burton. And again, the punting unit will come on.
But, you know, again, Montana had time to throw the ball. He has time to look over the entire field.
So Carrier and Metcalf are back in twin safety, awaiting the Aguiar punt. Joe Montana, 12 of 18, 106 yards and a touchdown. And Aguiar able to get it to Metcalf. Metcalf trying to go wide and had nowhere to go. Eric Metcalf run out by Darren Anderson, a 47-yard punt. and a 12-yard return.
You know, these two guys, Carrier and Metcalf, they're talking to each other. Now they split. You see how they stayed together in tandem? Now Aguiar doesn't see where Metcalf is. He kicks it to Metcalf. Before, Carrier was on the left. But now when Metcalf goes up in, he shows you his speed. Watch him get to the outside. He makes it out there.
And he ran it for 12, which is just about his punt return average, which is third in the AFC. So good field position for the Browns. They start out from the 50, but they have not been able to get anything going. 5:19 remaining in this first half. Hoard to the outside. And a good run by Leroy Hoard, taken down by Jay Taylor, the left corner, playing for the injured Mark Cullens. A reminder tonight, Tim Curry is in control of the planet's creatures, and he's using them against the colonists on an all-new Earth 2. Followed by an all-new Sequest. And then Robin Cook's new bestseller comes to NBC. Joanna Kearns and Gregory Harrison star in the world premiere of Mortal Fear. That's tonight, starting at 7, 6 Central here on NBC.
And we're in our all-new outfit.
Off the second and two, Leroy Hoard picks up the first down. William White, the free safety, runs it out. Yes, going with the official cold weather NBC Parker and Paul and his classic turquoise turtleneck.
Thank you very much.
And there is the president and owner of the Cleveland Browns Automobile. He called last week's win at the Vet in Philadelphia the Browns' biggest victory in some 15 years. Not enjoying what he's seen thus far in this first half. Play action for Testaverde on first down, and it was thrown off, intended for Hartley.
What a terrible pass. And I mean, it's a terrible pass. You've got Hartley wide open. You have all the time in the world to throw the ball, and you try to, like a little jump pass. It's throw the football. They're tentative about throwing the football. But another thing, too, you just ran the ball a few times, got a first down. Hoard's running very well. You've got the defense setting back a little bit. Go ahead and run it. Nothing wrong with that.
Testaverde now 0 for 5. Rippon started the game. He was 1 for 7. It's a second and 10 at the 37 in Kansas City territory. Testaverde incomplete. Intended for Carrier.
These two guys look like they've never thrown the ball before. I'm not kidding you. This is unbelievable. I'm watching two quarterbacks. We had Rippon first and couldn't get close to a guy. And Testaverde is sitting back here. He can't get close to anybody either. And they have people open. And they have time to throw the ball.
The Cleveland quarterbacks have combined on 1 for 13. It's been all Kansas City in this first half. Total of 5 yards passing for the Browns. Third down and 10. Carrier 83 in motion. And it is, was it caught? Yes, it was. Brian Kitchen able to hold on. Jake Taylor try to strip him. And that is the first completion for Testaverde.
This is the first time that Testaverde has thrown the football. And I'm talking about throw it as a quarterback. Problem is that Kitchen isn't beyond. Taylor is right there. He's not beyond the first down marker. Taylor makes a good play. And the Browns are going to go for it. They're at the 30-yard line. Fourth and about four.
Testaverde will throw, swings it out, and they do pick up the first down. Leroy Hoard runs it out of bounds, down to the 20, covered by Derek Thomas.
That time they got Thomas to the inside, and they held him there, and Leroy Hoard comes out of the backfield, and what a great play. Number 33 is on your screen. You see Derek Thomas gets caught up, and he can't get out to Hoard. Hoard makes an excellent catch, most important, keep the ball, hold on to the ball, and get the first down.
So the Browns have a first down at the 20, and Vinny Testaverde has completed two passes. Back to the ground. Hoard stopped by Thomas. Leroy Hoard has been held in check in this first half.
What did Leroy Hoard tell us? Derek Thomas can be a factor in the ball game, and he said, you know, he could catch it from the backside. This is getting caught from the backside. Thomas down the line of scrimmage. You've got to have somebody come back and pick him up. If you don't, he's going to make the tackle. That, folks, is for no gain.
9 carries, only 27 yards for Horford. 8th play of the drive, 2nd and 10. At the Kansas City 20 with 2:20 to go. First half. And the Chiefs up 7-0. Testaverde. Incomplete. The pass intended for Carrier. Covered by Carter.
See, that time with Derek Thomas, what they did is they had Hartley, the tight end. Now, he's blocking on him. And when he gets done, Thomas is a little tired, but when he gets done, watch this. This guy will block first. You see this guy here? Now, watch to the right of him. Will be the tackle. As Thomas comes inside, Jones is sitting there waiting on him. But that's what you have to do. You know, when they talk about, you know, Derek Thomas, they said the easiest way to control him is to run right at him.
It is a 3rd and 10, and you saw people jump and a penalty marker down.
This is a fatigue foul. Derek Thomas is tired. He's on the line of scrimmage, and he comes a little early. A little early. They blow the whistle now when a guy has a free shot at the quarterback, even though this was a running
play. Offside, number defense, number 58. Unabated move toward a quarterback. 5-yard penalty. Repeat 3rd down.
It's that running unimpeded to the quarterback that they're aware, that they're worried about. He's right here, and when he comes across, watch, there's nobody to touch him. Even though this is a running play, he has a direct shot at the quarterback. So they blow the whistle. That's nice. I like that. Saves quarterback.
It's a 3rd and 5 at the 15 as we come up on the 2-minute warning. Cleveland has 3 timeouts, all 3. Kansas City with 2 left. And the dump off to Metcalf with running room. And Metcalf runs it in for the touchdown.
What a play that was. I mean, that was the easiest touchdown play that they've had in a few games, I can tell you that, because what happened is Metcalf gets lost in the middle. It looks like they're going to throw the ball to the flat somewhere else, and they throw the ball right up the middle of the field. And you really don't expect the offense to do that.
Eric Metcalf with his 4th touchdown of the season, 3rd as a receiver. And Matt Stover will look to tie it up. Now, no, apparently they're going for 2. Bill Belichick looking to take the lead. Cleveland is 4 for 4 in that department.
Just remember, that ball's on the 2-yard line.
And it is Horford stopped. Well, Bill Belichick with a gambling move, going for 2 to get the jump. And Pellant McDaniels, the man who is playing for the injured Neil Smith, got the reps on Leroy Horde, and Kansas City holds on to a 1-point lead. What's your feeling about Belichick going for 2 here?
I'll tell you right after I show you this here with Metcalf. Watch him get lost up in the middle. You see him right here? Now he goes, it's almost like a middle screen, and he just outruns the secondary. Now, what do I think about it? Have you been struggling for an entire half of football for 28 minutes? You finally get on the scoreboard. I kick the extra point to go into that halftime with a tie. I mean, I know your defense is strong, but I mean, and then this play, you run into the teeth of their defense, and the teeth being 58. I mean, this does is fuel Kansas City offense and defense. I don't like the call.
Paul, when the 2-point conversion was brought into the NFL, it was used in the old AFL. Most of the coaches did not care for the rule because it brings on all kinds of possibilities, but you rarely would see in a low scoring contest early in the game where a coach would go for the 2 points.
Yeah, you want to go to, you got 2 minutes and 9 seconds. Your defense, granted, they are playing well. Your offense is struggling. You have a chance to tie the ball game at this point in time. I think you just go ahead and tie it. And then go in at halftime. You're comfortable with maybe a tie at halftime.
However, had it worked, it would have looked
been
like
genius.
A
been
brilliant
a genius.
Move.
Yes.
And wait, then so let's cover all the aspects.
Well, wait, I would have changed my mind then.
Now the kickoff. from Stover. And here's the return by Ron Dickerson. And we now have 2 minutes remaining. Little extracurricular activity after the tackle.
Von Booker, number 99, he isn't playing right now, so he wants to get a little activity.
So 2 minutes left in the first half. Kansas City by one.
KFC presents the Colonel's Playbook. What will the Raiders call on the final play of the game? Should they run a sweep, a sprint out pass, or try a draw?
Over the years, some pretty hungry folks
have stopped by my place.
The Mega Meal from KFC is back.
I like Mega Meal.
Your choice of chicken, a ton of side dishes, even a whole pie, all just $14.99. And this week, get a Tweety Mug.
Hurry, he's flying out the door.
Just $1.99 with every Mega Meal. Collect all four. The Mega Meal from KFC. Enough food to feed your whole family. Or one Tasmanian devil.
Sweep, sprint out pass, or draw. On the final play of regulation, the Raiders called a sprint out pass to win their 1993 regular season finale. The winning call from the Colonel's Playbook.
Hey, Flyboy, comfy in there?
Unless you check the hard side suitcase, we have a major crisis downstairs.
You thought Coach was bad.
It's a war zone down here. That's why I checked the Samsonite hard side.
Hey, isn't that your bag?
When you check a hard side, your clothes won't come out looking like origami.
Sir, could you please return to your seat?
Samsonite hard side. Life is hard. Don't go soft. What's this thing do?
It was supposed to be the fountain of youth. Then something went wrong. It
causes the body to age years in just days.
Robin Cook's bestseller, Mortal Fear, NBC tonight.
It's NBC's Lilith Tuesday, with an all-new Wings, a special Mad About You, and Lilith's returns with all-new Frasier. NBC Lilith Tuesday.
Coming up at halftime, the Domino's Pizza halftime report. Rick, Mike, and Joe back at the studio. They'll run down all the scores and highlights and a chat with Bills linebacker Darryl Telly. That is all coming up back at the studio. 2 minutes left in the first half, Kansas City 7 and Cleveland 6. And the Chiefs back to the offense. The pass intended for Lake Dawson, but an interference call on the right corner, Don Griffin. Don Griffin, a former San Francisco 49er and a San Francisco teammate of Joe Montana.
Don Griffin is complaining. He had his right hand knocking the ball down. The question is, where was his left hand?
Number 28 defense.
Where was his body?
First down.
So like Montana, he's not going to sit on the 7-6 lead with the 2 minutes to go. Let's go for it. Let's get some more.
The Chiefs from their 40-yard line. Lindsey Knapp now in a left tackle for Derek Graham, and a problem with the snap. And the Browns have come up with the football.
Boy, this, you know, you're talking about the field's wet, the ball's wet, and you've got to make that connection. It's the second time we've seen it. The one on Everett with Griffin, he just centered the ball early. Grunhardt is the center with Montana. The ball just doesn't seem to get back to Montana. It looked like Grunhardt came up too quick when he centered the ball. Watch Grunhardt come up. He comes up real fast. He might have short-armed it.
And Rob Burnett, the left defensive end, who has had an outstanding season, was able to recover the fumble. Break for the Browns. They take over at the Kansas City 39. Michael Jackson is flanked to the left side. That's Metcalf in motion. Horn. Leroy Horn broke a tackle and then was run out after a short pickup.
He just ran right out of the arms of McDaniels, number 77, the defensive end, playing in place of Neil Smith. Strong leg drive. There's fellow McDaniels on the end of the line. Now watch what Horde does. Watch his leg. Now he'll come up in the air and break this tackle. Just strengthen his legs. And only picks up 2 yards, but very importantly, he stops the clock.
Minute 45 remaining. in the half. It's a second down and 8 at the Chiefs 37. End around Metcalf. And Jay Taylor was able to make the stop. Now, Paul, you're saying you really enjoy those
end-around
plays.
Yeah, yes. I really do. Watch this here. Carrier is going to try and make a block, but he knows if he does, it's going to be a clip. And you'll see 83 on the right-hand side of your screen. He's just going to get out of the way. See him getting out of the way. He's got his hands in the air. And here's that wonderful end-around that lost 5 yards. I love him.
And I would think particularly tough on the reverse with the field conditions the way they are.
Because you're going to have to make a sharp cut as you get to the corner instead of straight ahead.
Loss of 4 and a 3rd and 12 at the 41. Testaverde taking the look. Flag thrown. Testaverde throwing for Jackson. And it's broken up. Michael Jackson covered by Darren Anderson.
Well, we got holding on the offensive line, and I'll tell you, Michael Jackson was doing a lot of pushing on Anderson down the field. You know, I don't know if you really take this penalty. Put him in fourth down in about 13. Why take the penalty?
Holding, number 69 offense, 10-yard penalty, repeat third down.
Darren Mickle, number 92, has hurt a defensive lineman, or it might just be cramps, but he's coming off the field on his own. But the reason I'm saying here now, all right, it is third and about 23, but you give them an extra down. I think if you put them in fourth down and let them make them punt, because they're not going to kick a 60-yard field goal in this mess.
And as you see, 55 seconds remaining. 7, Brown 6, Brown scoring a touchdown and then going for a 2-point conversion, which failed. 3rd and 22. Screenplay. The catch by Biner. And he is stopped well short of a first down by Vaughn Booker. Backup defensive end, a first-year player from Cincinnati.
We got another injured Kansas City Chief.
It has been a brutal stretch for the Chiefs. Vaughn Booker is down.
They're running out of linemen in a hurry.
7 starters are sidelined, including 4 offensively, 3 defensively. On the defensive side, Neil Smith is out along with starting left corner Mark Collins, starting strong safety David Whitmore. You saw Mickle limp off a moment ago, and now Booker shaking up. Look at the missing Chiefs. Marcus Allen with a sprained left knee. The Chiefs hoping he'll return next week. John Ault, the starting left tackle, and the word on John Ault is that he could be out another week with a disc problem. Willie Davis, sprained knee. He'll be out several weeks.
Marcus Allen, we just saw Neil Smith a moment ago.
And the tight end, Keith Cash, underwent knee surgery, is expected back later this season.
The MASH unit.
Yes.
Wow.
Cleveland Browns with only 82 total yards. Mark Rippon started the game. Could not get anything going. Completed 1 of 7 for 5 yards, and that was it. Then Vinny Testaverde came on, making his first appearance after missing 2 games with a concussion. And Testaverde only 4 of 11 for 36 yards.
Vaughn Booker is a backup player, and all right, here's Vaughn Booker right here. Let's hold on and just take a look at, maybe we can see what happens here. There's a block there. He comes in, he makes the play, and he comes down, and he lands right on his head.
Well, the crowd reacts, and that is a great sign. He's able to stand up.
The only other time I saw a guy land on his head like that was when Beebe, remember Don Beebe? He used that in the highlights a lot for the Buffalo Bills. He landed on his head. He was fine. But he came straight down on his head. He's going to have a sore neck for a long time, I'll tell you.
Vaughn Booker came to the Chiefs by way of the Canadian Football League, played for the Winnipeg Blue Bombers past couple of seasons. Tom Tupa will punt to Damon Hughes. And Hughes lets it bounce. Down to a half minute remaining.
Oh, this is nice. About four Browns went up and just started whacking number 42, Charles Mincy. Everybody wants to take a shot at Charles. He's just standing around.
34-yard punt. And the clock is now stopped with 27 seconds remaining in the half. And the ball is placed at the 10.
Let's drop this puck up.
So the Chiefs first down at the 10-yard line.
You know, the Browns still have, according to the scoreboard, have three timeouts left, and I wouldn't be surprised if they used them and forced them to punt down here.
And Montana hands it off to Hill.
Timeout. Take a timeout.
And the Browns do take that timeout, stopping the clock with 19 seconds remaining in the half.
What they have to do the same thing on these timeouts as a quarterback does. What a quarterback is told to do, Marv, when you want to have a timeout, and you have the referee is standing right there, he says to the referee, as soon as this play is over, I want a timeout. Now, what they should do with the linebacker, whoever is the team captain on defense, say to the umpire, who is Ron Botchin, look it, as soon as this play is over, it's blown dead, I want a timeout, and I'll be looking for you. And I know, you know, you can't just stand there being aware, but you still have to call it. But at least you make the official aware of what you're going to do.
Cleveland has two timeouts remaining. Kansas City is down to one. I mentioned a moment ago that Lindsey Knapp came on for Derek Graham at left tackle. Graham has been starting for John Ault. And the word on Graham, he was forced out because of a twisted right knee, and his return is questionable. So physically, it gets worse and worse for the Kansas City Chiefs. Second and six. Hughes in motion. Montana off the play action. Incomplete. Intended for the tight end, Tracy Green, covered by Eric Turner. And we're down to 14 seconds to go.
And I guarantee you, right after this play, whether it be a run or a pass, I think on that play right there, Montana tried to use up a little bit more time by rolling out, get the clock moving, and obviously would have liked to have completed a pass, but wasn't looking at something downfield just to keep that clock moving. He knows that the Browns, here they come, in a hurry to the line of scrimmage. Look at this. Well, the clock, the time went out. They ran out of time. Done a play clock, and Johnny was running up to call a play. They were in the huddle. The clock wasn't moving.
Offense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
See, that's the play clock. There are 14 seconds on the game clock, but this puts him back further. The rain is coming down again. And believe me, they'll go after the punter.
It's a third and 11. The handoff is Greg Hill, and Cleveland immediately calls for time with 10 seconds remaining.
Only 4 seconds off the clock. Now you go after it. You don't lose anything. Scott O'Brien is a special teams coach. You go ahead and go after it, because they're going to have to keep, if you show that you're going to come after the punt, what that does now is that brings all 11 guys inside. It doesn't allow you, from the Kansas City standpoint, Marv, to split out a guy. Because remember, those are the only two guys that can go downfield before the ball is kicked, are the two outside guys on either side. So if you show blips and coming at the punter, punt block, then that means that they've got to bring these people in. Now, you're still back there. You're going to have Metcalf and Carrier.
And you saw head coach Bill Belichick also get involved in that special teams huddle. Bill, a one-time special teams coach, so this is very close to his heart, and the Browns have done a terrific job of that department. Scott O'Brien in his fourth year with the Browns. Came to Cleveland from the University of Pittsburgh, where he also handled special teams. Here's Scott O'Brien. 10 seconds to go as Aguiar gets set to punt from his end zone. Here they come, and Aguiar got it away.
Out of bounds.
Down to 5 seconds.
Well, he kicks the ball out of bounds. He should have had the ball in play. He kicks the ball out of bounds. It goes out of bounds at the 40. It'll be 7, a 57-yard field goal here. Why not take a shot?
27-yard punt by Aguiar. And Matt Stover will. 4-for-4 last week. 18 of 20 for the season. He has connected on 12 in a row. And this will be a 56-yard attempt.
Well, they must be hurt in Kansas City because I see, first of all, Vaughn Booker is back in the game. That's good news. But I see Darren Meikle, number 92, limping onto the field. He's playing.
And the Browns will take a timeout.
Marv, remember one thing, that the guy that's holding is Tom Tupa, who is a quarterback. Now, with Kansas City having all 11 guys up on the line of scrimmage trying to block this thing, you've got a guy that can throw the football. Don't be surprised to see them throw this thing of the fake field goal with Tupa.
Browns have taken their final timeout. Getting another look at the distance. This would be a 57-yard attempt.
Well, after all that said, here comes the offense. Testaverde. So we covered everything again. Testaverde will take one and throw it to the end zone. Now that makes the Kansas City Chiefs. They change all their people. Well, I thought I was really going to be clever with that.
It was a good thought.
Tupa pass. A great thought. But
would have been a lot of pressure on Matt Stover chasing the record of Louis Rosa, who has hit on 14 straight, a franchise record. And so instead, the offensive unit is back on with 5 seconds remaining. And Testaverde will fire one down. Throws the Hail Mary with Michael Jackson in the area, and it's incomplete. And that was close.